Hi friends, today we are going to discuss metal joining processes, that is unit number 4 in subject manufacturing process 1. Myself Mr. S.P. Udgave, assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, EDRA. Content: types of joining processes, advantages and disadvantages of welding method, classification of welding processes, types of welding, and lastly we can discuss the arc welding method. Joining processes includes welding, brazing, soldering, adhesive bonding of materials. They produce permanent joint between the parts to be assembled. They cannot be separated easily by application of force. They are mainly used to assemble main parts to make a system. In that, welding, it is defined as a metal joining process in which two or more parts are joined at their contacting surfaces by suitable application of heat or pressure. Sometimes welding is done just by applying the heat alone without pressure, or we cannot apply the pressure. In some cases, both heat and pressure are applied, and in other cases only pressure it is applied without any external heat. In some welding processes, filler material is added to facilitate joining method. Welding, it is also having the some advantages and disadvantages, so we can discuss the advantages of welding. Welding provides a permanent joint. Welding joint can be stronger than parent material if proper filler material it is used that has strength properties better than that of parent base material. It is the economical way to join the components in terms of material usages and fabrication costs. The other methods, that is assembly, requires drilling of holes and usages of rivets or bolts, which will produce a heavier structure. Disadvantages of welding: so labor costs are more since manual welding is done mostly. Dangerous to use because of presence of high heat and pressure. Disassembly is not possible as welding produces the strong joints. Some of the welding defects cannot be identified, which will reduces the strength. Joining process, it is classified into 5 groups. First one, mechanical fasteners. Second, adhesive, welding, brazing and soldering. So mechanical fasteners also classified into 2 categories. First one, that is a non-permanent one, and second one permanent. Also fusion welding, that is a welding, it is classified into 2 sub-categories. First one fusion welding, second one solid state welding. In fusion welding there are 3 sub-categories. Again, there is a fusion welding, it is classified into the thermal welding method, electric arc method and resistance welding method. In thermal, gas welding, thermite welding and electron beam welding. Electric arc welding, it is also classified into 2 subcategories, that is a consumable electrode and non-consumable electrode. In that, numbers of methods we can use for the welding purpose. That is a consumable, in electric arc welding method, we can use consumable electrode, that is a shielded metal arc welding method. Gas metal arc welding method, it is also known as a MIG welding, and last one, that is a submerged arc welding. In non-consumable electrode welding method, we can use a tungsten inert gas welding method. This method, it is also called as a TIG welding method, and last one, that is a plasma arc welding method. And last category, that is related with the welding, resistance welding, in which that is a spot and seam welding. Again, there is a classification of welding processes. We can take the collective information that is related with the arc welding, consumable and non-consumable methods. So different types. First, that is a gas tungsten arc welding method, gas metal arc welding method, that is a MIG welding, and shielded metal arc welding method, submerged arc welding, plasma arc welding method, and flux arc welding method. Resistance welding also having the four types, that is a spot welding, second one seam welding, projection welding, and resistance butt welding. Other types, that is a gas welding method, that is a having the subcategories, that is a depends on the type of fuel. So first one, oxyacetylene welding method, oxyhydrogen welding method, air acetylene welding method, pressure gas welding method. Thermochemical welding process is again classified into thermit and atomic hydrogen welding method. And last one, radiant energy welding method, that is electron beam welding and laser beam welding method. Types of welding, that is basically classified into two subcategories, that is a fusion. Without any pressure, only we can use the heat and we can do the fusion welding method. And second one, that is a solid state welding method, that is a we can apply the pressure without heat, or with heat we can complete the solid state welding method. Fusion welding, in fusion welding process, heat is applied to melt the base metal. In many fusion welding processes, a filler metal is added to the molten pool during the welding to facilitate the process and provide the strength to the weld joints. When we cannot use the filler material in the fusion welding method or operation, that method it is referred as a autogenous weld method. So this fusion welding method, it is having the types, that is arc welding, resistance welding. This is having the arc welding, resistance welding, gas welding, electron beam welding and laser beam welding. Next one, there is a solid state welding. In this method, joining is done by application of pressure only or combination of heat and pressure. Even if heat is used, the temperature in this process is less than the melting point. Metal, it is being welded, that is not like a fusion welding method. In this method, we cannot use the filler material. So this solid state welding method, it is again classified into three categories, that is a diffusion welding method, friction welding method, it is also known as a stir welding method, and ultrasonic welding method. Diffusion welding method, there is a two part surfaces are held together under a pressure at elevated temperature and the part joined by solid state fusion. Friction welding method, that is a joining occurs by the heat of friction and the plastic deformation between two surfaces. Ultrasonic welding, that is a moderate pressure, it is applied between the two parts and an oscillating motion at ultrasonic frequencies is used to direction parallel to the contacting surfaces. So one of the method we can see, that is a arc welding process. This is arc welding process. It is a type of fusion welding process in which melting and joining of metal, it is done by the heat energy generated by the arc between the work and electrode. That is without any applying any pressure, we can complete the arc welding process. That is the electric arc, it is generated between the electrode contacts and the work. Then quickly we can separate to maintain the gap between the workpiece and the electrode. The temperature near about 5500 degrees Celsius it is generated by this arc. This temperature, it is sufficient to melt most of the metal, the molten metal consisting the base metal and filler, that is solidifies in the weld region. In order to have seam weld to the power source, that is a moves along with the weld line. So see the figure. In this figure we can see the power supply, that is a provided AC power supply, it is a AC or DC power supply source, it is a provided, and two cables, that is a one of cable, it is a connected to the electrode holder, and another cable, it is a provided to hold the workpiece with the help of clamp. That is a electrode cable, it is a connected with the electrode holder, that is a connected with the consumable or non-consumable electrode, and that is a also we can use that is a filler material. That is a sometimes we use the filler material, and that is a direction it is a shown. So actually that is a glimpse also shown in the side figure. That is a that this is the machine, and the this is the working method. So we can use a power source in arc welding. Both AC and DC can be used. The most of the time that is a DC, it is used for the better arc control. It is possible with the DC supply. So two types of polarity, that is a for welding method, that is a straight polarity or reverse polarity. Straight polarity, in which the workpiece is positive and the electrode it is a negative, it is a suitable for the shallow penetration like in a sheets and the joints with the wide gaps, that is a for the low depth. And reverse polarity, in which we can use the workpiece it is a positive, workpiece it is a negative, and the workpiece is negative and the electrode it is a positive, it is suitable for the deeper welds. Electrodes, so two types of electrodes we can use, that is a consumable and non-consumable. That is a consumable electrode that is a present in the form of rod or wire with 200 to 450 mm length and less than 10 mm diameter. This is source of filler rod in arc welding. The electrode it is consumed by the arc during the welding process and added to the weld joint as a filler metal. The consumable electrode will be changed periodically as it is consumed for each welding trials. This becomes disadvantage of welder and reduces the production rate. So continuously we required to change the consumable electrode, so that is a time consuming, so lower the rate of production. Non-consumable electrode, the electrodes are not consumed during the arc welding, though this is the case. Some depletion occurs because of the vaporization. The filler metal must be supplied by means of the separate wire that is fed into the weld pool. So arc welding method, it is having some advantages and disadvantages. So we can see the advantages. Most efficient way to join the metal, lowest cost joining method, affords lighter weight through better utilization of materials, join all commercial metals, provides design flexibility. So these are the some advantages, and also having the disadvantages, that is a manually applied, therefore high labor cost, need high energy causing danger, not convenient for disassembly, defects are hard to detect at the joint. Application of arc welding used for fabrication work and maintenance work. This process finds application in shipbuilding, pipe and penstock joining, building and bridges construction, automotive and aircraft industry. So in stay connected for the next video that is related with the shielded metal arc welding and the submerged arc welding. Thank you.